So far in Digitalk segment, we've had so many people with us. We've had writers, we've had entrepreneurs, we've had businesswomen, businessmen, even people from the stock market, digital marketers, a DJ, a musician, a rapper, event management firm owner, and the list is quite lengthy. So on the 22nd episode, we thought, why not take a little bit of pause and look back at whatever we have done so far. Look back at the best of conversations with these people. Well, to be honest, the whole idea behind Digitalks is to bring forward these people who started with hopes, aspirations, and dreams, and what they did to achieve them. And they are as normal as all of us are. They just had the drive to achieve what they wanted to. All very well established in their respective professions. Also, not to forget the fact how digitalization impacted their growth and helped them out. Bringing to you a wonderful recap of these 21 episodes of Digitalks.
How do you think digitalization has helped you grow?
See, it has definitely helped me a lot, but you know, there's a very big problem with digitalization. It gives you a quick success and leaves you with quick nothing.
Yeah.
You know, when I say that, I mean to say people will go up and then after some time somebody else will go up and then you'll be like, what happened to that guy? And nobody is caring about that. In the old times, what used to happen, when Rajesh Khanna ji ghar se nikalte the, to aksar log unko, matlab agar wo ghar ke aaspaas bhi honge, to unke liye milne ke liye hazaron ki bheed jama jati thi. वो अब नहीं हो सकता. वो कुछ लोगों के लिए होता है पर अब नहीं हो सकता, बिकॉज हर एक आपने फोन अगर आपने रिप्लाई भी कर दिया तो लोगों को लगता है कि मेरा मोटिव सिद्ध हो गया, यू नो, ही जस्ट रिप्लाइड मी एंड द थिंग इज डन. कमिंग बैक टू डिजिटलाइजेशन, इट गिव्स यू क्विक सक्सेस. हाउ लॉन्ग इट स्टेज, यू नेवर नो. आई सॉ पीपल हु गॉट सो बिग इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी इन अ डे एंड देन दे आर नोवेयर. दे डेफिनेटली हैव द लाइक्स एंड यू नो ऑल द एनालिटिकल थिंग्स व्हिच यू वांट ऑन सोशल मीडिया टू बी देयर. दे ऑल हैव दैट. But I don't think they can run a home out of it. So you need to get out and do something about it. And imagine, let me break it down to this. If imagine AI comes up.
Yeah.
And all these robots come up.
Yeah.
They would destroy everything which is already there. Because they all the knowledge they'll gain. And that's how it's going to be like. So, I don't know, maybe. I just feel it's not going to stay for long.
But don't you think it's about how you strategize?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. But you do not get my point. What I mean to say, जैसे कि मैडी बहुत famous हो गया आज, let's say, okay? But on the stage, when people called me to perform, I was not sounding nice. So quickly went up.
Yeah.
And next day he was like, oh, he was not a good performer, he was not a good performer, he was not a good performer, and you're gone.
So your point is that there are too many options for
too
people.
Many options, quickly going up and quickly coming down. So आप कुछ छिपा नहीं सकते. It's absolutely transparent. वो जादू वाली चीज नहीं चलेगी कि आप ट्रिक यूज कर रहे हो और लोगों को बता नहीं रहे. नाउ इट हैज टू बी एवरीथिंग क्लियर. इफ यू आर गुड यू आर गुड, इफ यू आर नॉट गुड देन यू आर गोइंग.
एंड आई थिंक इट्स आल्सो अबाउट यू हैव टू कंसिस्टेंटली बी एंगेज्ड विद योर ऑडियंस.
एब्सोल्युटली. आई विल पुट इट डाउन इन वन लाइन टू यू. इट्स डिजिटल सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट.
Great. Digital survival of the fittest.
Correct.
That's nice.
Let's talk about your association with Intac and Vice India. Is it true that they approached you through Instagram?
My Instagram was the key reason why I landed up with a job at Vice India and Intac. For Intac, I led heritage walks in Delhi. And for Vice India, I was writing journalism pieces about hard news stories that were taking place in India. So the key here is to follow the right people and make sure that you build up on your interests and it reflects on your account.
Do you agree that a good book needs equally good promotions? And also, how do you think digitalization has affected the whole process of publishing books?
Yes, I agree. No matter how well your book is written, no matter how pithy your narrative, no matter how interesting your story, you know, we now have this powerful tool of social media. Social media and promotions, etc. It enhances the outreach of your product. And packaging, of course, is equally important, because I feel that a nicely written book can be even better sold if it's packaged properly. So yes, social media and promotions and everything available to us, it's a great advantage of the writers of today, which perhaps wasn't there at the time when my mother was writing her books.
So now talking about the digital marketing and the entrepreneurs, what do you think ki aise kaun se top 3 ingredients hain ya 3 qualities hain jo ek digital entrepreneur mein hona chahiye?
First, I think technology updates. Every day kya transform ho raha hai technology mein, kya nayi cheeze aa rahi hain, uska awareness hona chahiye. Every day study and learning. इस तरीके से उसको हम अपने नॉलेज बेस में ऐड कर सकते हैं. सेकेंड वन थिंग, हम डिजिटल की बात करें तो डिजिटल का जो कोर बेस है वो डिपेंड करता है हमारे सर्च इंजन्स पर. सर्च इंजन का इन डेप्थ कॉन्सेप्चुअल नॉलेज होना बहुत जरूरी है. कैसे वो फंक्शन करता है, किस तरीके से वो किसी भी कंटेंट को सर्च करके डिलीवर करता है, अगर वो कॉन्सेप्चुअल हमने इन डेप्थ एनालिसिस करके और उसको एक तरह से अपने नॉलेज बेस में ऐड कर लिए तो हम किसी भी प्लेटफॉर्म पे किसी भी कंटेंट को इजीली डिलीवर कर सकते हैं और उससे रिलेटेड गोल्स को अचीव कर सकते हैं. सो आई थिंक दीज आर द फ्यू थिंग्स जो कि एक डिजिटल एंटरप्रेन्योर के लिए.
Traders Talk is a platform where you advise people in terms of stock market, where to invest, in which stock to invest.
Yes.
And this whole process is online. And yes, you also provide courses to students.
Yes.
Right. So how did you execute this plan and what were the challenges that you came across while you were doing this?
So as I said, I was already trading in markets when Traders Talk actually came into being. So it was like three, four years already. I was already in the market and I was a very active trader. I was basically trading all the things, stocks, options, futures. I was doing everything. So basically, when I thought of, you know, giving Traders Talk a platform, I first created a website.
Right.
So after creating a website for a month or so, I just switched on to Facebook. And that was the best thing I did because Facebook acted as a platform to attract many, many clients for me. So when I started my Facebook page years back, so I got the first client within the within 15 days of creating that page.
That's pretty fast.
Yes, that was pretty fast because I was participating in some of the forums also stock, which were related to stock markets. I was answering queries to of the participants there. So that actually acted as a very, very good thing for me, and people actually recognized there that okay, somebody is there who, you know, who can answer our queries. So from there I started to gain traction. So I got my first client from there, then word of mouth also worked for me, then he referred some clients to me. So it was, I did not have a very challenging task to gain clients as and when I started. Mm-hmm. And then it is also about how do you maintain that, you know, pace.
Yeah, that so, picture, that reputation.
Yeah, right. It is also about, so you get first 15 clients, then you have to, you know, get keep on getting those clients in order to sustain that business. So that is more challenging. Right. That is why I started my blog. My website was already there. My services were already mentioned in the website. But then I thought that if I blog every day,
right,
because I was already giving posts in Facebook, I was already participating in some forums. But then I thought if I blog every day, I talk about some stocks, I talk about some specific sectors. So I maintain, it is kind of maintaining an online diary.
Right.
So blogging is very much crucial if you want to keep getting, you know, recurring clients.
Now talking about SEO, you are an expert in SEO as well. What do you think is one thing that business owners usually go wrong when they're dealing with SEO?
Most of the business owners are following same old tactics, which is actually hurting their rank in Google. They are doing same things which we were doing before 10 years. But now due to recent updates from Google Penguin and Panda, you will get penalized if you follow those tactics. And most of the business owners are still following the same.
So the key here is to keep updating and keep following the new trends and everything
that's
in the market.
You have to follow the recent updates. You have to keep continue check of Google's recent algorithm updates.
Right.
How is Instagram helping you get your clients in terms of getting digital marketing services as well and selling out the clothing?
See, there are two segments that we actually work on. It's not that everything is online, because Weirdo was firstly a digital marketing based website.
Right.
Now it's purely e-commerce. And how Instagram is helping, our first goal of getting the 10 sales, the first 10 sales, was purely organic. So our idea was more about touching the strings to the hearts of people So when they are connected to us, when they are talking to the brand, we actually sell.
Right.
Not directly, but indirectly. Indirectly. Yeah.
Writing poetry and quoting stuff, then we saw that people are connecting to us.
Right.
They are DMing us. And they are also posting their ideas.
Right.
So we credit them. That's
so it's not that you're directly selling out the product, you're firstly connecting with the audience and
currently,
then you're telling them that okay, this is the product that we have and that's how you sell it. That's great, that's a great idea. So similar to Instagram, you also have a very good number of followers on Pinterest.
Yeah.
How is that going?
So on Instagram, we have that we need a 10k follower thing to actually organically drive traffic to the website. So that's when we started exploring Pinterest more.
Hmm.
So we see a lot of quotations there, a lot of things putting on in terms of clothing brand.
Right.
To be very honest, it's really good for a clothing brand to choose Pinterest as a platform.
Hmm.
So Pinterest actually helps us to directly drive traffic organically to our website.
How did I acquire my clients? So, you know, to be very honest, it was never intentional. I never intended to get client. But when you are good at something and you are really passionate about something, you've been appreciated and then things just fall into places, you know. That's what happened with me, I guess, because I always try to promote a healthy living and try to make people understand the power of yoga. That's when I have got an opportunity to teach a young group of people in an educational institute, and soon after that I started my Instagram page in the name of Gemini Yogini. Gemini is my zodiac, my sunshine. So in that way I started my Instagram page. I started posting not only yoga posts but also promoting the lifestyle and health post as well. And it has got many genuine followers, you know. So things just fall into places, as I said. And then after I have been called for many workshops, to conduct workshops and sessions in the offices and all. And afterwards, I think there's no look back. And word of mouth plays a bigger role here, and also references work here. So that's how my whole process of getting an exposure has started.
Now that the digital age has grown, it started with Facebook and Orkut. Now everything is on social media, everything is on the internet.
Yeah.
How do you think it has helped your academy grow?
Not only academy, it has actually turned the game upside down.
Mm-hmm.
I remember when I was a DJ, when I started DJing, you know, finding good music used to be a task. If you make music, promoting it used to be a task.
Mm-hmm.
And somehow YouTube, internet, SoundCloud, Spotify, all these channels just changed the game. Today, if you are talented, you really want to reach to the audience, you don't have to go and, you know, really run around
beg
with the record,
people.
Beg around the record labels,
just
run around them, or maybe you have to shed a lot of money.
Right.
If you're talented, your product has quality, it will reach to the audience just like that.
Right.
So, of course, when I started with the academies, my first thing, and till today, we have tried and tested a lot of methods, like, you know, flyers, college partnerships, sponsorships. But
traditional marketing
but now from past I think 2.5-3 years we don't follow any of the traditional marketing. So we are only active on internet. Internet is our source of bread and butter, actually.
Right.
Even for my events, even for everything. And that's where we market, that's where I personally market. I'm very active on social media.
Right.
I 3 years back, you know, I had a company, they used to handle social media for me, but again, my few friends, they said, no, you do it yourself.
Right.
So again, you know what happens if you don't know something, people try to make a fool out of you. So few companies try to make a fool out of me. Then I thought one day that why not to learn.
Right.
And that's what I even suggest to a lot of my entrepreneur friends which are there, or they're good businessmen which are there. I said, don't take a lot of time. Do a 1 month course from any academy.
So how did you go about acquiring clients? Was that a challenge for you?
It still is a challenge.
So what do you do about that?
So, see, acquiring clients is all about, you know, delivering the best quality that you can and as per the industry standards, and being true to what you do rather than, you know, just promising something and delivering something else. We only focus on quality.
Yeah. Right.
And that's the only reason why people want to work with us. And of course, like today we get a lot from people that, you know, oh, you guys are expensive.
Okay.
But when you are sticking to certain benchmarks, you tend to be expensive.
Right. Well, talking of acquiring clients, one of the biggest, it is one of the biggest challenges indeed. But recently that we've had digitalization in the world,
right,
and especially in the last 10 years,
right,
how do you think it has changed and how do you think it has helped you?
See, as such, when people talk about digitalization and going into a lot of digital analytics and a lot of digital promotions in terms of paid promotions,
right,
that's something that we've not been doing till now. We've just been putting whatever events we've been doing, whatever content we had on our social media. For me, the breakthrough was when I got a call from somebody at American Express that, you know, we found your page on Google, your Instagram handle on Google, and we believe that you've done a few stand-up comedy events, so, you know, we want you to come down and organize a stand-up comedy event for us.
Right.
So that was the breakthrough for me for digital media, though it was a little late, but today when I talk about the artists we manage, the content that needs to go out, the promotions for the event,
right,
of course on ground is there because, you know, those have been the benchmarks, but today of what we see, the how we convert the reach of any product, be it a song, be it any event, be it gathering more footfall on an event, be it a music concert, it's all digital today.
What is the number one key of influencer marketing?
That is number one. Content is the king, like Sarah always say. Ki bhai, content ke upar to kuch bhi nahi hai. Other than that, there's consistency, of course. You have to be consistent. Demotivation hoga, fir bhi you have to be consistent. And other than that, entertainment, find your niche. Wahi same cheez hai.
Okay.
Again.
Let's talk about hashtags now. What are the popular hashtags in the food fraternity nowadays?
Zingy zest. Hashtag Zingy zest. I haven't done it. Instagram has list. So it has a hashtag Kolkata foodie, hashtag Indian foodie, Indian street food, hashtag Zingy zest also.
That's nice. Congratulations. And what about you?
The same hashtag.
Same, also
yeah,
the same.
Food blogger.
Yeah, but I think
Delhi blogger.
Key,
Delhi.
But I think the key is also, you know, to stand out. Because you know ab itne sare food bloggers ho chuke hain na, so aapko alag kuch karna hoga, you know, because when a log meri jagah kuch aur dekh lenge, main bhi wahi khana wahi restaurant mein daal raha hu jo koi aur daal raha hai, so how do I make it different, how do I, you know, make it stand out, ke alag dikhe, so that is very, very important.
So you have to be creative enough. So that was a walk down the memory lane. I hope all of you enjoyed it. Well, so did I. All these guests set wonderful examples for us to follow, for all the youngsters to follow. We will be bringing many such people in front of you. Till then, stay tuned.